on the next Rick and Morty.
All right, Morty, you ready for our adventure to the lost city of Atlantis?
Ready as I'll ever be, Rick!
Rick and Morty, next Sunday night at 11:30.
Whoa! Yeah! Atlantis, baby!
Certainly 306 is circling the psychological concept of there's bad parts of us that we have to get rid of, and then we'll be happy, and then we'll be healthy.
Rick and Morty are gonna get their toxins removed, all the stuff they don't like about themselves is gonna get sucked out by a sci-fi machine, and off they're gonna walk better people.
Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. They pay the consequences for that, let me tell you.
In this season so far, we've seen Rick deeply hurt by Morty choosing the Vindicators over him. And we've seen in the past, clearly deep down, he really does care about his family. He cares about what Morty thinks of him.
If you suck the things that make Rick bad out of Rick and you base it on the customer's point of view, then Rick's identity is going to be saying, well, I know what's always holding me back. It's this tendency to want people to love me.
What are the toxins? They're the emotions. They're the things that you don't like about yourself. If you remove the toxins, that doesn't leave you as a better you. It leaves you as a weird, different, bad version of you.
Then you end up with hateful Rick, but also vulnerable Rick.
Morty this season has been growing as a person. He is becoming more confident, yet if he were to lose the part of him that's not cool and, you know, everything that makes him lovable, then we see what happens.
Boing, 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 sucked everything out, everything that was holding me back, everything bad.
Cool.
So it's not so simple as this is good Morty and evil Morty. This is two parts of Morty that should be together.
Hey man, the stuff that we think are our worst qualities, still a part of who we are. Just gotta fucking own it.
You know, it's easy to think that the gunky, toxic Rick and Morty are the bad Rick and Morty, but by the end of it, they're the ones with emotions. Gunk Rick is the one that cares about Morty. That's the stuff we want to get rid of from ourselves so that we feel better, but that's also the best part of ourselves. Think about it.
Hey everybody, new Rick and Morty, but you guys also might have heard about the big schedule change, so I'll explain what's going on with new episodes, because it's coming, but it's not coming next week. So I'll say, you know, just because everybody's really pissed off there's no new episode on Sunday, there is a new round of the Zen Monkey Studios merch giveaway. All you have to do to enter, just be a subscriber, leave a comment on this video. As the promo implies, self-contained adventure, like this is just the episode description that they gave off. They're going to Atlantis, it's going to be fun. That means when they say self-contained, that they're probably not going to deal with divorce stuff. We might not see Jerry, it might just be Morty and Rick down in Atlantis. But they haven't revealed too many plot details. There was this weird thing a couple weeks ago, like right up until they released the official title for the episode, where everybody was calling it Tales from the Citadel. So I don't know if that was a working title or where people pulled that from. So when people saw the word Citadel, they're like, wait a minute, are they talking about the Citadel of Ricks? Is this some sort of Citadel of Ricks episode and they've just moved their base undersea to Atlantis? But again, all the episode description reads is a self-contained adventure down at Atlantis. It doesn't say anything about the Council of Ricks. And I think the whole point of that scene at the end of episode one where he teleports the ship, crashing it into the galactic government, is that he sort of takes care of the two groups that have been coming after him for different reasons, so that for the majority of season three episodes, they don't have to deal with those people coming after Rick all the time, because otherwise you'd have to address that. Like, Rick could do something crazy and the council would port in and try and haul him off again, or the galactic government would be on him all the time. So it was just kind of the culmination of the season two plot with the government and a way to tie up the Council of Ricks for at least a little while, or at least keep them busy. I've seen a surprising number of questions about the Council of Ricks. You just have to remember that there's an infinite number of realities, so the council was just made up of a portion of them, so it stands to reason that they'll replenish their numbers eventually and they'll come back. But in the way they haven't brought Mr. Poopy Butthole back right away, or they haven't even brought in Phoenix Person and Tammy back right away, they probably just wanted to focus on new story stuff and not recycle too many old things, but they'll bring that stuff back eventually. Like, I think the finale will address some of the Phoenix Person stuff, because the title is the Rickturian-Morty date, and if you haven't seen the Manchurian Candidate, there's a couple different versions of the movie. It's basically a Winter Soldier story where a good person gets brainwashed and turned into an assassin, which is kind of what happened to Phoenix Person. But there was that Bird Person Easter egg during episode 5 when they're all going through the wormhole and their mind space, their realities all sort of blend together. When Jerry opens this door, he's sort of opening the door to Rick's mind.
Those aren't the questions you should be asking.
Huh?
Shh.
So what you're seeing is actually a lot of the things that are happening in Rick's mind in metaphor form, like they presented in this really crazy Twin Peaks way that's meant to be confusing. So you see the bust of Bird Person and Beth on the fireplace here. And because this is sort of Victorian room, it's the place of high honor. So it just shows where Rick is putting his most important things inside his mind. So obviously Beth, his daughter, is the most important thing to him, his family. But you also see Bird Person here too, which means that he hasn't completely forgotten about him. So one, it's meant to be this really funny, horrifying scene. But remember, this is all of people's thoughts and emotions, the things that are going on in their head. So it's just meant to remind you what's coming in the future, things that are unresolved in Rick's head. Speaking of other things they're bringing back too, a lot of you have probably guessed correctly that episode 9, titled The ABCs of Beth, is actually based on the anthology series The ABCs of Death, which means that it might be an interdimensional cable episode because they've done one every year and they sort of tease that they're going to be doing it again. They just didn't say when it's going to happen or what it's going to look like or the stuff they're going to try and do. The description reads, Jerry is lucky with a lady and Beth recalls her childhood. So the anthologies, the different stories, will probably be snippets of Beth's life scenes from what happens when Rick goes away from her perspective. So he goes off on a 20-minute adventure, is gone for 6 days, and then, you know, something happens to Beth when she's a little girl. She just has to learn things on her own. So maybe in addition to interdimensional cable, you'll also get to see the weirdness of Beth develop as she tries to sort of form her own personality with Rick being gone on adventures all the time. But no confirmation for Beth's mother. We haven't seen anything about whether or not she's going to pop up this season. There was the teaser in the first episode that wound up being that fake Breaking Bad reality, but the writers did confirm that every lie has an element of truth in it. So there are some things about his wife in this that are true. They just didn't say what parts of it are true. But I don't think it's going to be some big twist where his wife shows up at the end of the series and says, I've been alive this whole time. I really do think that she's dead. But the big question is she dead in every single reality? Because the whole thing is that Rick just replenishes his Morty. They have the whole joke in the opening credits sequence where he's at the Morty store trying to pick which version of Morty he wants to use. Right now, I think the idea is they just want to have this story about crazy grandpa with Morty going on adventures and the family dealing with it. And Rick's wife isn't a big story element that they wanted to push into right away, so they just chose not to address it. So I don't think they've ever said that there is no version of Rick's wife in any of the dimensions. They just said nothing. So I think they're just leaving the window open to do whatever they might want to do with her down the road. They don't want to write themselves into a corner, which I think is the right move. If you over-explain things right at the beginning, then when you want to change things down the road, it causes all kinds of continuity errors. Game of Thrones is having that problem right now with the White Walkers and the Night King. They're big antagonists of the series. They've changed the rules about how you kill them. So I think Rick and Morty is just trying to tiptoe around some of those story problems. So the biggest reason why Rick's wife hasn't shown up yet is because they don't want to over-explain the Rick character and make him seem less complex. Like, he's much more interesting when you don't know exactly what's going on in his head. When you can clearly state 1, 2, 3 reasons why he does everything that he does, it just makes it way less mysterious, way less cool. But if we're going to be seeing Beth's childhood, if his wife isn't already gone and out of the picture, then they'll have to address her somehow. So it'll be interesting to see how they do that. They might do the Peanuts or the Muppet thing where you hear her voice, but you don't see her on screen. Let me know in the comments, though, will you be okay if they don't explain Rick's wife at all this season, even though they kind of teed that up in episode 1? I feel like it'll be fine as long as they loop it back around to Phoenix Person. They have to resolve that plot in some way, even if it's not completely. But just a reminder, because of Labor Day in the United States, no new episode on Sunday. Episode 7 will air in 2 weeks. Obviously, I'll be doing bonus videos, so I'll just remind people of the schedule when I post new Rick and Morty. But there'll be some new Game of Thrones coming tomorrow. I've got a new Marvel trailer. There's some DC Flash Season 4 stuff that'll post tonight, too, if I can get it out fast enough. So congratulations to the latest giveaway winner, Tyler Belliston. Please private message me on the back end of my channel so I can get your contact details. There'll be a new round of the giveaway the next time I post Rick and Morty. So while you wait for everything, click here for my episode 6 Easter eggs, and you can click here for brand new Game of Thrones. Thank you so much for watching. Everybody stay awesome. I'll see you guys tonight.